Hello, welcome to the Wolfpack. My name is Hamster C3. Welcome back to... Anyways, hello, welcome to the Wolfpack. My name is Hamster C3. Welcome back to My Sweet Roomies. Yeah, I hope we can get this video done in time because my head's really hurting, but I have to get this video out. Anyway, let's get on with the video. Ren? What do you mean? I don't understand your feelings. This one's fine. However, she is, has a hurt expression on her face. Oh. I think I get close to Ren, but Ren pushes me and runs out of the room. Wait, Ren! Ren, another light, just me. Oh, damn. What did I just do, Ren? I'm unable to chase my and just sit there, overwhelmed with regret. Chapter 48, Boundaries. A few days have passed since I fought with her. Ren hasn't come back from the license yet. Ren, it looks like she's staying with her parents again. This is the third day in a row. I wonder what happened to Ren. The girls turn older and turn faster. Ren, did you fight with Ren? I don't think she's avoiding Ren. It's more like she's avoiding you, Ren. That's why I'm trying to speak. She looks worried. Hey, don't tell me you and Ren. You're not gonna break up, are you? That's. I can't happen, but I can't say that. Ren might already hate it. I hurt Ren badly. Ren, you don't understand my feelings at all. Ryan. Those words pierced right into my heart. I don't know what she was thinking when she yelled at that. She had no idea. I don't understand Ren's feelings at all. I might even be qualified to be her boyfriend. For the days continue, Ren was crushed by regret, and the time keeps passing. I feel like if this keeps going on, I think there might be a moment where I try to commit suicide in the game because of this. Today's the day that Ren hasn't come home to play. I have no classes to, but somehow I can't relax. I go outside as a fresh air. Then, Ryan? Huh? Ren's dad is actually telling us something. However, he's actually showing me. Ren's dad, who is always so calm, follows me and flushes me. Great. I wanted to ask you something. Huh? Huh? Has Ren come by? Ren? No, she hasn't. I see. Wait a minute. Did something happen? Ren, I asked. Ren's dad answered in tension. Ren's been staying with us for 2 days. With us. Last SMS the past 2 days. But she got sick, right? She took the safe baby. And Ren was supposed to be sitting in her room, but she disappeared.
What?
What do you mean she disappeared? I swear, if you did anything, I will kill you. I will sicko kill you. Ren's dad continues speaking with
only a question on his face. I called the college, but they said she hasn't come in. If she didn't go there, I thought she might have come here, but Ren has disappeared. And she's sick. Wait, what do you mean she's sick? Ren hasn't been sleeping at all lately. She also hasn't been eating. She's been very depressed. I thought she was having problems with you. Perhaps? No, it's definitely because of our fight. Anyway, will you help me look for Ren? Okay. That's right. Today, I have to find Ren. If she's sick, where on earth could she be? I take a quick glance around there and then I see her. Ren? Wait, she was here the whole time? Huh? That was weird. I'll play again. Play this game. Just as I decide to go for a run here from the street, her dad glances behind him. With him. And he sees her. Run! Huh? And she can't run saying her feet. None. Run staggers over. Run!
Run!
I leap forward and reach out to grab her. Run! You have a fever.
What should I do? I'm tired of you.
Ryan. Yes? Ryan stands and scared up on his face and he falls to his knees and hands. I'll look after her bed. Ryan, can I use a bed? Use my bed on the first floor. I'll carry her there. I'm sit this way. I start running, feeling unsteady in my feet. While I listen to Ryan's dad's orders, I'm on the verge of panic.
Ryan!
Only the thought of saving her keeps me sane. Okay, I'm desperate to save one. And then. Oh, I think that is important. Thank you all for talking. Bye, guys.